The following is a presentation of Sunday Night Sports, recognized throughout Southern California as the leader in sports insanity. Please rise for our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light? What's so... I can't hear it.
To Allen Lee fleeing.
And the rockets rattled, the bombs bursting in air. Gave proof through the night that our flag was still there.
Oh, save the Star-Spangled Banner, yet
fantastic. It's unbelievable. Fans everywhere are jumping for joy. It's time for the coveted Hall of Shame Awards. Plus, we span the world in search of the greatest plays as we salute Rogan's heroes. It's Fred Rogan Sports Bowl 87. Dare I say it? Let the games begin.
Thank you, Don Pardo, and good evening, everyone. Welcome to our biggest night of the year. We've got a lot to show you, and this year we have changed the ground rules just a little bit. Now, there are going to be three segments. The first is Rogan's Heroes, the second, the Hall of Shame, and the third, a salute to the winners. But before we get started, we're going to present the highest honor anyone can achieve. It is the Hall of Shame Governor's Award. And we present this for outstanding technical merit. You know, directing a live event might be the toughest job in all of sports. There is crisis after crisis, and the director is the man that holds the show together. Well, this year's award is presented to the retiring Bill Baboon, who has directed over 1,000 Houston Rocket games throughout his illustrious career. And now a look at director Bill Baboon's final broadcast.
Okay, you bunch of baboons. We're going to have a good time here tonight. Yeah, it's going to be a good game. Everybody's going to have a good time. Let's be loosen up, not be nervous. It's going to be a great time here. Okay, good. Put one up. All right, here goes the tip-off. Oh, that's a great way to start this. Hey, that looks good, too, over there. Take two. Ready, two, take two. Take two, take two. You're the slowest TD in the world. Two, what are you doing to me? You puke. Get me somebody in charge. Kyron, we need number 50, Ralph Sampson. Number 50, Ralph Sampson. Ready, put it in? Put it in. No, it's spelled wrong. Oh, my gosh.
They say that video is no good.
Video, video. Talk to me, video. Tell me something, please. Will you get off the switcher? Will you please get off the switcher?
Oh, I give up.
Billy, presenting the award, the chief executive officer of the Hall of Shame Foundation, the legendary Hans Henderson. Way to go, boss.
Next, fall in troops for Rogan's Heroes.
I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good, so good. I got a year. Wow, I feel nice. The sugar runs by. I feel nice. The a sugar is fine. So nice, so nice, I got you. Hey!
Now, since we're all loosened up and feeling good, we're ready for the great plays. It's time to salute Rogan's Heroes. We'll start with the best sacrifice of the year, Julio Franco with a foul pop. B.J. Surhoff of the Brewers sacrificing his body to make the play. The most unusual assist here, Steve Jeltz with a shot off Mark Grant's glove, over to John Kruk, who made the play. Not even Kruk could believe that one. The best magical move by an infielder, Danny Walling of the Astros, up his arm, into his hand, across, and they've got him. The best catch of the year, Wade Boggs with a fly ball to left field. Darryl Boston of the White Sox is going. He's going. He's gone. And he's got it. Outstanding grab by Darryl Boston. The best stretch of the year took place in Milwaukee. Foul ball down the line. The fan in the stand stretches out. Will he get it? Will the ball boy get it? Will the fan get it? Will the ball boy get it? Will the fan get it? Yes. He's got it for the best stretch of the year. In tennis, the best behind the back between your leg shot goes to Ann White. She didn't get the point on this one, but she did come up with an incredible shot. The shot of the year in tennis belongs to Yvonne Lendl, not for the backhand, but for the behind the back backhand. For the luckiest basketball shot, we go to Illinois because it's better to be lucky than it is to be good. The most acrobatic shot belongs to Dr. J, who could still do it in his final year in the NBA, off balance and swish into the hoop. The best underhanded shot belongs to Trevor Johnson of Bel Air Prep for heaving at 75 feet. Perfect. The longest basket goes to Oklahoma's Stacey King. And the most memorable shot of the year belongs to Magic Johnson for his bomb against the Denver Nuggets. Moving to boxing, here's the most unusual knockdown of the year.
A good hook.
Oh, a double knockdown, James.
A double knockdown.
Unbelievable. We've never seen that here.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Now we salute this year's Purple Heart winners, whose biggest achievement was surviving. Joel Bartlett from Seattle, Washington, taking a tumble in the Mickey Thompson off-road race. He got up, got back on his machine, and finished the race. It was a small miracle for Max Toller, who was involved in one of the worst motorcycle spills you'll ever see. Unbelievably, he was back on his bike and ready to go. Fasten your seatbelt as Jim Cropfield turned his hydroplane into a 747. It flipped over once and came in for a horrifying landing, a scary moment. Luckily, he came away with only minor injuries. At Los Alamitos Racetrack, every harness driver's nightmare became a reality when one horse suddenly went down, then five more took a spill. Without question, the biggest wreck in harness racing. Fortunately, no one was hurt. At the Talladega 500, veteran Bobby Allison blew a tire, and suddenly he was airborne, crashing violently into the safety wall. He spun out of control, minus the back end of his car. Allison was dazed, but okay. The richest golf shot of the year belonged to Lee Trevino. On the 17th hole of the Skins game, Trevino got the bounce, and he got the ace, worth $175,000. Absolutely reason to celebrate. The pressure shot of the year belongs to Larry Mize for his incredible chip at the Masters. Here's our golf expert.
What an incredible Cinderella story. This unknown comes out of nowhere to lead the pack. At Augusta, he's on his final hole. This crowd has gone deadly silent. Cinderella story, out of nowhere. A former greenskeeper now about to become the Masters champion.
It looks like a miracle. It's in the hole! It's in the hole! The crowd is standing on his feet here at Augusta, the normally reserved Augusta crowd. Going wild.
In hockey, the most memorable goal of the year scored by Flyer goalie Ron Hextall, who cleared it the length of the ice against the Bruins, just the second NHL goalie to ever score. In football, here's the best catch. It was Jim Calcavecchia going deep for Lewis Bennett, a defensive back in his face, but somehow Bennett played the ball off of his back and in for 6 points. The best execution on a play, Villanova with the old swinging gait. It worked for a touchdown against Holy Cross. The longest punt of the year, Cal Scott Tabor punting out of his own end zone. The ball takes a hop and rolls all the way down to the 1 yard line before it is finally downed. And the best body of the year belongs to Miss Olympia, Corey Everson. Those were the memorable moments. Coming up next, the not-so-memorable moments. And we'll get to them after this important message. It takes incredible stamina to rule a nation. You have to be fit. You have to be trim. You have to be ready to run at any moment.
Exhale. Shh. Wake up and breathe.
And through this incredible TV offer, you can stay fit with Ferdinand Marcos. Yes, it's Marcos size.
Change. I'm gonna tell you.
He ruled with an iron fist, and now he pumps iron for you.
You gotta work, you gotta sleep. It's gonna hurt, but be brave.
Yes, you too can possess the incredible physique that drove a nation wild. Not available in any store, operator standing by right now. And if you order before midnight tonight, you'll also receive the latest exercise shoe from Nike, Air Imeldas, available in over 3,000 styles and colors. Ferdinand Marcos, Marco size. Get yours today.
Stay tuned. The Hall of Shame Awards are about to begin.
Please remain seated once the Hall of Shame Awards ceremonies begin. If you leave, I'm sorry, you will not be allowed back in. Now, the Hall of Shame is our look at the not-so-memorable moments from the world of sports. So sit back and relax for the 1987 Hall of Shame Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, the torchbearer has entered the stadium as the world's finest athletes perform the traditional Hall of Shame choo-choo. Our first award tonight goes to javelin thrower Seppo Rahti for the shortest throw in javelin history. Way to go, Seppo. Now to the hard-hitting world of boxing.
Are we ready?
This year's award for unbelievable audacity while entering the ring goes to kickboxer Anthony "I'm Bad" Elmore. Anthony had everything but his opponent under control.
Crowd reacts to that, spinning back.
There's a little short, beautiful right hand.
Award for best 1-2 punch goes to Tony Lopez, whose motto is, one, you knock him down, two, you make sure he stays there. Best left delivered by Pernell Whitaker, who was right on the money. The best right presented to the fan, who made his point on the Philadelphia Eagle picket line. This year's Giving is Better Than Receiving Award is presented to Tyrone Downs by Roger Arvalo. It's the kind of gift that lasts a lifetime. While we're in the ring, now the prestigious Edward R. Murrow Award for Future Journalists.
This is Megan.
She went to Cal State College out at Fullerton. She'd like to be a newscaster.
No question about it, a future Pulitzer Prize winner. This year's Olga Corbett at 40 Award is presented to Paul Hunt, who dresses like a woman and performs gymnastics. Smile, Paul. The judges are carefully evaluating his style, his poise, and his grace. No question, he brings a new element to gymnastics.
Oh.
The element of pain. Now, heads up. We're going to take a couple of hacks at baseball. The Temper Award goes to Roger McDowell, who was so upset that while trying to throw the ball into his glove, he nearly threw it into left field. Best attempt by a ball girl took place in Montreal. Line shot off the wall. She's on her horse. She's going, wait, don't touch it, don't touch it. It's a fair ball. Nice try. The Missed Him By That Much Award goes to Vince Coleman. The Lucky It Missed Award goes to a preoccupied cameraman who was out of focus on this play. In the unlucky division, everything went blurry for Al Nipper, who is now pitching for the Vienna Boys Choir. And of course, joining him is umpire Greg Bonin. Now it's time for the Childish Fan Sacrifice Award. Watch the ball closely. See the fan that caught the ball? Look what he dropped to catch it. His son. Sorry, Dad, no Father's Day gift this year. We interrupt the Hall of Shame Awards for this special bulletin. Air raid, down, down. Too late. Now it's time for the Cowardly Matador Award. After an 1,800-pound bull ran over this matador in Spain, he ran for his life, which apparently does not go over with the fans at a bullfight. One fan came out of the crowd to discuss the matter, whereupon the other matadors decided to join into the conversation. The bull was still in the ring and had no comment. Dragging on to our equestrian event, the treasured Whoa Nelly Award goes to rider Hap Hansen, a victim of happenstance.
Look at him go! Look at him go! What a spill!
On the water, the award for innovations in ski jumping goes to Tarp George for this reverse spread eagle face flop with a half twist. That's a 10 in our book. Nothing could bail out our Row, Row, Row Your Boat Award winners. It didn't matter how many oars this crew had in the water. Now, it's off to the links for the Tipper Chipper Award. And it goes to the former Speaker of the House, Tip O'Neill, who had little to say about his liberal play. The Keep Your Eye on the Ball Award goes to the ball boy seated next to the net. We warned you, keep your eye on the ball. All right, folks, time to take a break. No, don't panic, Junior. We're coming back. We're coming back with more, we promise. Right after this special offer.
And now, for a limited time only, Hall of Shame Records and Tapes proudly presents the best of the worst of John McEnroe.
What did I say, umpire? Tell me. Please tell me. Just please tell me!
Yes, it's all here. Those insults and outbursts you've come to treasure in a complete 12-record set. Who could forget?
You guys don't know what the hell is going on!
And of course, there's the classic...
That's my question! The question, jerk!
And I'll bet this brings back nightmares. Yes? It's a timely collection from that sniveling whiner in the Teddy Cloth headband, the best of the worst of John McEnroe.
Yes. What the hell is he doing on the court?
Order now and receive a special bonus, mascots who should be hung.
Will you destroy Winnipeg? You know why? Because they're ugly.
Don't miss this once-in-a-lifetime offer. Order now.
Welcome back. Let's kick off part two with the inaugural Kickoff Classic Award. It's presented to Bonzi Colson with our best wishes. The Double Dribble Award goes to Michigan State coach Judd Heathcote. The Pick and Roll Award goes to the fans at Central Michigan University who pick out a player and throw a roll of toilet paper at him. The You've Got Your Nerf Award goes to the legendary Navy Nerf Head. A footnote, a stunt like that should be attempted with Nerf balls only. Unfortunately, we do not know who the winner is in this year's Bobby Knight chair throwing competition. The coach promises to notify the winner by telephone. The You Can't Make Me, You Can't Make Me Award goes to 88 Keys, who refused to get on track. And if you think that ruffled his feathers,
Toucan and Dog Biscuit and Girdle in the stretch. And now they come down to the wire, and there goes the winner!
Saddle up, partner, for the Hall of Shame Rodeo Performer of the Year. Was there any doubt? It's Tex the Wonder Monkey. And what a performance in the wild mutt ride. He's on Benji, one of the meanest, but there's no throwing our champ tonight. The Cowpoke Award goes to these young mutton busters. You know mutton busting, where the men are boys and the sheep know it. The Auto Club Award goes to stranded motorist Doc Bundy, whose car caught on fire, so he called for help. And he waited, and he waited, and finally decided to play Dodge Car, running across the track to get the extinguisher, and then he ran back. Like they say, if you want it done right, you have to do it yourself. This year's Keep It Simple Award goes to Mets broadcaster Ralph Kiner for his explanation of a save.
Roscoe came in and finished out the ballgame a little shaky. Didn't get a save because of the rules. He did not pitch three innings, and he came in with the on-deck batter being a batter that he would face in his next approach to pitching to the hitter.
Thank you. That cleared it up. The Boomerang Award goes to the goalie in Spain who scored on himself. This year's Slip and Slide Award goes to the San Diego Sockers and Los Angeles Lasers. Next time, have to remember to tack down that floor. Now everybody hit the ice. It's time for hockey. The Stick It to 'Em Award goes to Ron Hextall, who stuck it to Kent Nielsen. The Stripper Award goes to Ulf Samuelson, who threw his stick at Anton Stastny. Then he threw both his gloves. Lucky he scored before he took his uniform off. The Leave the Fighting to Us Award goes to these players who were interrupted by an overzealous fan who wanted in on the fun. Hey, buddy, leave the fighting to us. Runner-up in the balloting, two trainers in New Orleans who took matters into their own hands. To the fighters' dismay, the battle outside the ring was better than the one inside. The Kiss and Tell Award takes place in the ring this year. During pre-fight instructions, Mitchell Julian on the left leaned over and kissed Roger Mayweather on the cheek. The referee threatened to penalize the next man to throw a kiss. Mayweather then planted a left and a right to Julian's cheek. And to prove there were no hard feelings, went over and kissed Mitchell Julian goodnight. Sweet dreams, Mitchell. The Climb Every Mountain Award goes to these motley motocrossers who were so mired in mud their motors could move no more. But neither mountain nor molehill could manhandle Murph the Mud, who managed a magnificent maneuver to finish in the money. Now, let's dive into football. What? Hold it. There's a flag on the play.
From our sides, defense.
Now, you've heard of a mental error. This is the Mental Catastrophe Award. Yes, it's the old tiptoe on the sideline, throw the ball up for grabs, and pray someone on your team comes up with it. Yes, it works every time. The Losing Face Award goes to the Seattle punter. Now, watch his helmet closely. Yes, he had his head turned by the Dolphins and couldn't face up to it. And hey, have you hugged your referee today? Finally, a salute to the photographers of the year, those unlucky lensmen who got in the way. Hey, buddy, open your iris. And the winner in the coveted close-up division goes to cameraman Marty Zimmerman, who had his focus wrecked on this play. Fine job, Marty, but we shudder at the thought.
Still to come, a special salute to the winners.
A's and some not so great. Now we're going to focus on the winners. Sports is a celebration of accomplishment and triumph. And some of the most memorable pictures come from the world of sports. So now a tribute to the winners for having the time of their lives.
Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth. And I owe it all to you.
Cause I had I owe it all to you.
I had
the time of my life. No, I never felt this way before.
Never felt.
Yes, I swear it's the truth, and I hope it.
Pretty good year. Congratulations to the winners and to all the competitors this year. That's our show. Thanks for being with us, and thanks for spending another year of Sunday nights with us. As always, the Hall now goes on its year-end sabbatical. Have a wonderful holiday season, a happy new year, and we'll see you in 1988. Good night, everybody.
Another year down the drain.
Is that it?
Jeez, I don't know.
I'm Don Pardo.